Next, we are going on to a clinic. Okay, a doctor's clinic. Of course, nobody will want anybody to go to a clinic because we don't want anybody to fall sick. But then, when you go to a doctor's clinic, how to go about it, how to speak to the doctor, and the terminology used at a clinic, all this you should know. Okay, so now the next topic is at the doctor's clinic. Okay, I'm just going to give you a very funny dialogue between Mani and Vani. Okay? Mani says, "Vani, where are you off to?" Okay, I'll just write it on the board. Mani is from the village, okay, and he knows only a little bit of English. He hasn't bought the DVD which you are watching now, so he knows only a little bit of English here and there. He can catch up and understand, okay. So Vani has been in the city and she knows English so well that she can speak well and also understand English better. Vani, where are you going? Vani. I'm off to the pharmacy. Money. You cannot go there. There are no farms. Vani, farms? What do you mean? You are, Mani says, you are using the wrong order. Isn't it? See, Mani thought instead of pharmacy, he thought pharmacy. Then only Vani understands. This Mani, he doesn't know proper English. He hasn't seen the DVD and all. He doesn't know spoken English at all. That's why he has thought of pharmacy as pharmacy. Okay? So she says, "Oh my." I said pharmacy. Which means a medical shop medical shop, or in America they say drug store. According to British English it is pharmacy, according to American English it is drug store. Not drugs and all medicines are called as drugs. Then Mani feels very shy, very ashamed for understanding it wrong, and he says, "Oh, I'm sorry," he says. "I misunderstood you." Okay. So this is just a light-hearted conversation between Mani and Vani, and I just wanted to use this word pharmacy and have a pun with it. Pun means to just have a joke with that. "Vani, where are you going?" Vani says, "I'm off to the pharmacy." Mani: "You cannot go there. There are no farms there here." "Farms?" Vani says, "Farms? What do you mean?" Mani says, "You are using the wrong order. Isn't it pharmacy?" That is, instead of see the farmer, he thought she is going to see the farmer. So, pharmacy. So, that's what instead of, you said, no, you said pharmacy, but actually he thought to see the farmer. Okay, and she explains later. "I thought you said see the farmer." Okay, then Vani explains, "Oh my, I said pharmacy, which means a medical shop or drug store." Mani: "Oh, I'm sorry, I misunderstood you." Okay, in English, certain words like pharmacy, it has a different spelling altogether. It doesn't start with a F, it starts with PH, but still, it has the pronunciation pharmacy. Okay, so what is a pharmacy? It's a medical shop. Okay, so I hope you've understood this terminology. Now we'll see more things regarding clinic or doctor's clinic. Now we are going to see. Okay. Okay, now you have an old grandmother at home and she slipped and fell in the bathroom. What would you do? Because old people, when they fall down, it's very, very risky. You should immediately inform the police. You should immediately inform a doctor and ask for his or her help. But no doctor will come, leaving all his patients, isn't it? So immediately you call for an ambulance, okay? Because it's very difficult for you to lift an elderly person, take them to the car or take them to an auto and take them to the doctor. So you call for an ambulance. Okay, let's see a dialogue now between, or how you should use a telephonic conversation at this juncture. We are going to see. Now Hema's grandmother has fallen down in the bathroom and she's calling up the ambulance. Okay. "Hello, is it RS Hospital?" "Yes, I need an ambulance immediately. My grandmother who is 88 years old has had a fall. In the bathroom, please send an ambulance to the following address. Number 32 Fort Cross Street, MGR Nagar, hospital receptionist. Yes, ma'am. The ambulance will be at your doorstep. At your doorstep or at your house within 10 minutes. Okay. See, nowadays is old people or elderly people falling down, or anybody like due to stress and strain, people getting a cardiac arrest, all this is very common. But immediately you should not think of giving any medicines on your own, okay? That is, medication should be done only at the hospital. So this case is, if you give your own medicines, it may prove to be very fatal. What do you mean by fatal? It may even take the life of that person. So you have to rush them to the hospital in an ambulance. Okay, so the same dialogue can be used for a cardiac arrest also. You can even say, my grandfather has had a cardiac arrest or heart attack. So I need an ambulance, send it immediately. Why we call an ambulance is, ambulance has a siren, isn't it? So when they sound the siren, other vehicles will give way for the ambulance to go. Whereas if you take your grandmother or grandfather in your car, they will not know, others will not know that there is a sick patient in the car. So they may not give you way, and that few minutes may prove to be very, very fatal. It may take the life of that person. Okay, so first thing, for an emergency, you should call for an ambulance. Okay, okay. Now I'm sure you've learned what to do at a time of crisis. So Hema, she calls up the hospital and she asks for an ambulance. Hello, is it RS Hospital? So she asks a question. I need an ambulance immediately. So she is not giving any story how her grandmother went into the bathroom and how she slipped and fell. All that is not necessary. All that you need is an ambulance immediately. I need an ambulance immediately. My grandmother, who is 88 years old, has had a fall in the bathroom. Please send an ambulance to the following address. 32 Fourth Cross Street, MGR Nagar, Mylapore, Chennai. And the hospital receptionist, yes ma'am, the ambulance will be at your house within 10 minutes. And she says, thank you. Okay, so first we saw what a pharmacy is. Now we have discussed how very important an ambulance is to go to a doctor's place, a doctor's clinic or a hospital, how it is very, very important. Okay, now if the patient's condition is very critical, where will they put the patient in? They'll put the patient in an ICU. What is an ICU? ICU. Intermediary care unit, okay, or intensive care unit. Intensive, that is very detailed, that is they won't allow other people to enter in, because those patients may catch the germs and other infections. So intensive means in detail, they look after the patient. Intensive care unit, okay. So they have different types of units, that is maternity ward. Maternity ward is a place where women, when they have their babies, they are treated in the maternity ward. And surgery is a place where anybody has to undergo a surgery, that is where they cut open the body and perform any operation, they are taken to the surgery. Okay, so in a hospital you find different places like this. Okay, in case you've broken your bones, like your hand or leg or your ribs, what do they do? Where do you go to? You go to an X-ray unit and take an X-ray. Okay, only then they'll find out whether the bones are broken, where it's broken, and they can give immediate treatment. Nowadays, even for dental surgery, they ask you to take an X-ray and come, so that they'll know where the tooth is broken or how it is rooted in the gums, everything. So with medical facilities, doctors find it very, very easy to treat a patient. Okay, so we'll move on to the next step now. What happens in the doctor's clinic? Okay, when somebody goes to a clinic, you sit in front, doctor asks you to sit in front of him and he examines you with a stethoscope. And whatever your ailment is, he gives or he prescribes medicine accordingly. Now, I'm going to give you certain conversations which the doctor may have with you, or what instructions a doctor would give you when you go to a clinic. Okay, first he may say, sit up straight, isn't it? And then he will keep the stethoscope and examine your heartbeat, your whether there's any phlegm in your chest and all that. Okay, so I'll give you some sentences which the doctors may use. Sometimes our spoken English DVDs may be useful even for doctors. They may be very intelligent, very knowledgeable in whatever subject they are dealing with. But to reach out to the patient, they need simple sentences which will make it easier for them. Okay, so I am going to give some sentences which doctors usually use as instructions. Okay, I will just write down doctor's instructions. Okay, I'm going to give you some common instructions that the doctors use to a patient. Okay, sit up straight, breathe easy. Okay, next one. Take a bland diet. What do you mean by bland diet? Bland diet means without much oil, without much salt, and without any spicy ingredients in it. Okay, bland. Okay, so all these terminologies you should know. Take a bland diet. Third point, bland diet, I told you, okay. Avoid hot spicy food. Okay, now this hot refers to not the warmth or that is the temperature. Here it means hot to taste. Not hot to touch, but hot to taste. Hot spicy food, that means with too much of masala and all that, you should avoid such kind of food. That is why take a bland diet, it's written here. Next, take a test. Take a blood test after fasting. Usually, when a person has diabetes, they take a test after fasting. What do you mean by fasting? That is, first you take a post-prandial test, that is, you go and give your blood for testing, and then they'll tell you go home, have food, and exactly after 1 hour and 45 minutes come back for test. So that is called fasting, that is without having any food or water. Water you can have without having any food at all, that's called fasting. So these terminologies you should know. Take a blood test after fasting. Take this syrup. Post meal and after meal. Post meal thrice daily. Okay, what does this mean? Take the syrup post meal thrice daily. Post means after. Okay, so you have to take that syrup every day after having your meals, that is breakfast, lunch and dinner, thrice daily, every day. Okay, so these are the small instructions that the doctor may give you. Okay, when you have wheezing, take a puff. What do you mean by this puff? It doesn't mean taking a smoking a cigarette. Okay, sometimes they say take a puff means smoking a cigarette, or puffs, something to eat. It's not that. Take a puff means, it means an aspirin puff, okay, the inhaler. Okay, I'll write within bracket. This puff means aspirin inhaler. Why I'm giving you all this is, when you go to a doctor and these are the terminologies a doctor uses, and if you don't know, if you don't understand, you may wonder what is happening. Okay, that's why take a puff means aspirin inhaler. Okay, next one. If your feet are swollen, keep your feet raised. Keep your feet raised. If you keep your feet raised, that is the fluid collection which goes to the feet will get back. Otherwise, all the fluid collection will go and rest in your feet and it gets swollen. Okay, so that's another instruction that the doctors give. Okay, what else? These are the usual things, and also doctors usually ask people to ask the patients to walk and exercise. Walk every day for at least half an hour. Okay, walking is a very good exercise. They say in those days, they'll say an apple a day keeps the doctor away. That is, those days apples were so full of nutrients that if you eat an apple, you need not go to a doctor at all, they'll say. But nowadays, even those apples are filled with all sorts of, pesticides and all that they put for their fruits, and that gets into our body and it causes, at times it causes hazards. So, what now is the in thing or the best thing is, walk every day for at least half an hour, and you can keep your body trim. Your body gets a lot of oxygen and it's a very good exercise. So these are the usual things that doctors generally give to the patients. Okay, so when you go to a doctor, what do? You tell him what your problem is. For example, good morning doctor. Yes, good morning, please sit down, doctor may say. What's your problem? And you may say, I have a bad headache for the past 3 days. And the doctor may ask you, have you tested your eyes? No sir, I haven't. So please go and get your eyes tested and then we shall see what to do next. Okay, this is one sort of a conversation. Or you may go to a doctor with a very bad stomachache. So the doctor says, yes, sit down. And then he'll ask you what your problem is. And you may say, doctor, I have a terrible stomachache. It's unbearable and I don't know what to do. I took some painkiller, but in spite of that, I have. Okay, please go and lie down on the bed, he may say. And when you lie down, he may press here and here and check, and then he may find out that you have some problem with your appendicitis. Okay, appendix, everybody has an extra bag which collects all the unwanted stones or things in it, and if there are stone collections in your appendix, it may cause problem. So doctor immediately may suggest that you go in for a surgery to remove that appendix, which is called appendicitis. Okay, so there are a lot of ailments like this. So you should be polite to the doctor, and also you should freely tell him what your problem is. Unless you tell him your problem clearly, a doctor will not be able to diagnose your problem. Okay, so next time you go, you please open up and tell exactly what you feel. Okay, and these are the doctor's instructions that he'll give you, and you should also now know to follow. Okay, I'm going to read another talk show on doctors. Okay, if you switch on the TV these days, after a certain time there'll be a hello doctor. Like, patients can call up and ask questions to the doctor stating their problem. Okay, hello doctor, and they'll call up and say, doctor, I like this, I've been having continuous back pain or this and that. So now we are going to see Sugam phone in show. Okay, this is like a TV program. This is called a Sugam phone in show. We have a compare and callers we have, and doctors. We have four different doctors. I'll tell you what each doctor's specialization is, and let's see what they are giving advice as. Now compare. Compare means the one who anchors the show. Okay, now let's go ahead. Compare. Welcome viewers to our Sugam phone-in show. This week we have with us Dr. Balan, pediatrician, Dr. Ammayappanar, geriatrician, Dr. Tulkapier, dermatologist, and Dr. Brian D'Souza, neurologist, Dr. Bonnie Rajkumar, orthopedic surgeon. We request our viewers to be brief in their queries and spell out their symptoms clearly. Remember, our number is 044-2827-9210. Here's our first call. Tring, tring, tring. Okay, they get the call. Caller 1 is on the line. Question to Dr. Tulkapier, please. Dr. Tulkapier. Yes. Doctor, I'm Harry, an 18-year-old college student. I have lost a lot of hair in recent months. I have an itchy scalp too. I have not changed my hair oil or shampoo. Recently, I drive a two-wheeler and wear a helmet. Could that be the reason for my hair fall? Okay, now to whom is the first caller talking to? Dr. Tulkapier, and Dr. Tulkapier is a dermatologist. Now, who is a dermatologist? Okay, dermatologist. Okay, dermatologist, Dr. Tulkapier. Now, who's a dermatologist? A doctor who deals with skin infection. Doctor who deals with skin infections. Okay, so it can be in the hand, it can be in the leg, it can be even a hair. Okay, so this caller 1 says that his scalp has become very dry and his hair is falling. So he wants to ask the dermatologist how it can be treated, and he's asking whether wearing a helmet all the time when he rides a bike is the main reason for losing his hair. Okay, Okay, now let's see what the doctor says. Certainly not, Mr. Harry. It is a myth that wearing a helmet will cause loss of hair. Your problem could be dandruff. Now, what is dandruff? Dandruff is a dry condition of your scalp. Scalp is the outer skin of your head, okay, within the hair. And if it's the skin becomes dry, it becomes scaly, and it that is called the dandruff. Check if there are white powdery flakes on your scalp. It is dandruff that is a major cause of hair fall. It causes itchiness too. Itchiness means scratchy feeling. Use anti-dandruff shampoo twice a week. Okay, Candid TV could prove effective. If you have an oily scalp, wash your hair regularly. If you have dust and dirt combined with all those, could cause dandruff. Also, use your own comb, towel, etc. Okay, after Dr. Tolkapur gave his advice, caller 1 says, thank you, doctor. And compare speaks now. Our next caller, tring, 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 the bell rings, and the next caller has come. Question to Dr. Bonnie Rajkumar. Who is Dr. Bonnie Rajkumar? Orthopedic surgeon. Who is an orthopedic surgeon? Orthopedic surgeon. Okay, orthopedic surgeon. Now here, let's see first what his ailment is. Before which, orthopedic means something to do with the joints. Okay, your legs, your hands, orthopedia. That means anything to do with the joints. Surgeon means one who performs surgery. Let's see the question. Yes, please, says doctor. Caller 2. I am Nikita, a medical transcriptionist. For the past 6 months, I have been having pain at the joint of my neck and spine. It arises when there is a jerk while traveling on my bike or when I bend down to work. Sometimes I also have giddiness. I had an x-ray taken and doctors said that I don't have spondylitis. I apply hot water fermentation and gels when pain occurs. How do I get rid of it? Okay, now where is the patient having the pain? In the neck. Okay, so the patient thought that it may be spondylitis. What is spondylitis? It is the inflammation of the bones in the spinal cord. And she thought it was that, and she took x-ray and all that, but it was not that. So she, when she gives hot water fermentation, what do you mean by fermentation? That is keeping the hot water in a rubber bag. You can just place it on the affected place. That is your place where you have the pain. When you keep it, that's called fermentation. Okay, it gives you a nice feeling. So when she does that, it gives her a lot of relief. Okay, so Dr. Bonnie Rajkumar says, your complaint is common among computer professionals. You need to take a few precautions. Precautions means to be careful about things. Do not work for more than 45 minutes at a stretch. Okay, like nowadays everybody is sitting in front of the computer working out all the time. So at a stretch, not more than 45 minutes. In case you have a full day's work at the computer, after 45 minutes you have to take a break, take a walk around, and then come back to the place. Okay, so that's what the doctor says. Always rest for 15 minutes every hour. Your keyboard should be close to your body. Your elbow should be bent at an angle while working. That is like this. Okay. If your elbow is bent only, your keyboard will be here, isn't it? If you put it on your lap, it's not good. The radiation will affect your body. So you should always keep it on a table straight here, and your elbow should be at an angle. And use a thin pillow at night. Don't use two or three pillows for your head. You should use a thin pillow while you sleep. Neck exercises are useful. Try these exercises. He demonstrates a few exercises on TV, like maybe changing or rotating your neck like this or something like that. The doctor may be showing. Okay, now orthopedic surgeon, doctor dealing with what? Joints, bone and joints. Okay, bone and joints in the body. Okay, orthopedic surgeon means one who performs surgeon means one who performs surgery. Okay, next let's see what the next caller says. Compare. There's our next caller. Tring, 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 tring. Okay, caller 3. Hello, is it Sugam phone-in show? Compare. Yes, it is. I'm Mrs. Guna. My question is to Dr. Balan. My daughter, aged 3, suffers from frequent cold, cough, and wheezing with fever. On several occasions, the child vomits food with mucus. We give her only boiled water. Doctors have diagnosed upper respiratory tract infection and prescribed medicines, which only give temporary relief. Now, whom is she calling? She's calling Dr. Balan. Who's Dr. Balan? Pediatrician. Who is a pediatrician? Okay, who is a pediatrician? Pediatrician is a doctor dealing with small children. Doctor for small children below 10 years of age. Okay. Okay, they are called pediatricians. Now, what did Mrs. Guna say? That her daughter is 3 years old and she has cold and fever. Let's see what Dr. Balan says. Many children have this problem, which is very recurrent when young. Don't worry, provided the child is active, gaining weight and sleeping peacefully. A child vomiting, especially after a bout of coughing, is not a cause for worry because it clears the airways blocked by mucus. Some preventive measures could be taken, like preventing her from playing in the mud, drinking iced drinks, or going into an AC room soon after sweating profusely, and avoiding smoke around the child, and continue the medicines, and her immunity will gradually improve. So what does the doctor say? This is a very common problem. So don't let your child sweat profusely. Profusely means too much of sweating. And immediately if the child goes into an AC room, that will affect the child and it will catch cold. Or drinking cold water from the fridge, that will also affect. And what else? He also says playing in the mud, because mud, it may have germs in it and that will get into the fingernails and get into the body. So all this they have to be careful, he says. Compeer says, viewers, please stay with us. We'll be back with you after a short break for the commercials. So this is a TV program and they have wound up the show. But there are a few doctors who did not come and give any suggestions. Who said? Doctor Ammayappar, geriatrician. Geriatrician. Who is a geriatrician? A geriatrician is a doctor who deals with old people. Okay? Doctor for old people, for elderly people, I'll say. Elderly people above the age of, or elderly people or senior citizens, we can say, above the age of 70, age of 60 plus. Okay, geriatrician, mainly 80-year-old people, 70-year-old people, they all go to a geriatrician. Okay, and who are the other doctors? Pediatrician, geriatrician, dermatologist, no, neurologist. Who's a neurologist? Who's a neurologist? Neuro means anything to do with nerves. Okay, doctor dealing with nervous problem. Okay, nervous problem. Whoever has any problem with nerves, shakiness and all that, they go to the neurologist. These four doctors only we saw at the TV show. But there are some more specialists whom I would like to introduce, which is not in that TV show, I would like to give you. I will clean the board now. Well, now I have written down all the specialists. Okay, when you go to a doctor's clinic or a hospital, you should know what to look for. Whatever problem you have, what to look for. You have nephrologist, you have cardiologist, you have dentist, you have neonatal specialist, urologist, gynecologist, ophthalmologist, diabetologist, gastroenterologist and oncologist. Okay, all these are the specialists in each field. Okay, our human body is so complex that doctors specialize in these subjects and they study. We just saw four different doctors in the TV talk show, isn't it? And who are they? Pediatrician, we say geriatrician. Then we saw orthopedic specialist and who else? And dermatologist. Four we saw. Now we are going to see 10 more. Okay. Who is a nephrologist? Doctor dealing with nephrons. That is, what is that? Okay, mainly dealing with kidneys. Okay, cardiologist, also they look into gallbladder and all that closer organs. Cardiologist dealing with heart. Okay, if a person has a heart attack, you should go to the cardiologist. if a patient has a kidney failure, you have to go to the nephrologist. Neurologist and nephrologist, you should always be very careful. Neurologist is with the nerves and nephrologist is with the kidneys. Okay. Dentist, dealing with teeth. Teeth and gums. Okay. Neonatal. What is neonatal? Born babies. We saw pediatrician. Pediatrician is only after 1 year old babies. Okay. We saw it in the previous talk show, isn't it? Pediatrician is only a doctor dealing from 1 year to 12 years old. But neonatal is a born baby to the age of 1. Born, newly born babies till 1 year. After 1 year, they go to a pediatrician. Urologist. Urologist is dealing with urinary problems, the urinary tract infection, urinary bladder. Bladder and tract. Okay. Urinary bladder and tract. Gynecologist is the one who deals with uterus. Mainly for women. A gynecologist is a doctor mainly for women dealing with uterus. Uterus is a bag which holds a baby in a mother's womb. Okay, uterus and etc. Uterus and also ovaries. Okay. Ophthalmologist. Uterus and ovaries. Oh, I'm sorry. Uterus and ovaries. Okay. Dealing with uterus and ovaries. That is reproductive system of a female person. Okay. Next, ophthalmologist, dealing with eyes. In case you have cataract formed in your eye, or you have a problem with your eyesight, you have to go to an ophthalmologist. Diabetologist. Nowadays it's become very common. Everybody seems to have diabetes. That is, the sugar level, the insulin level, if it increases, the patient becomes a diabetic patient. Okay. Dealing with the sickness of, with the sickness of rise in sugar level. Sugar level in a body or insulin level in the body. Gastroenterologist. Many people have this problem when they have food, there seems to be a thunder and a storm inside the stomach, and they may have problems later. So that is a gastroenterology. Okay, that a person dealing with a digestive system. digestive system in a body. Okay, and last but not the least, oncologist. Oncologist is a doctor dealing with cancer in any part of the body. Oncology, dealing with cancer, dealing with a disease called cancer. Okay, so you have learned now, when you go to a hospital, whom to look for what ailment. Nephrologist, dealing with kidneys. Cardiologist, dealing with heart. Dentist, dealing with teeth and gums. Neonatals, dealing with born babies till 1 year. Urologist, dealing with bladder and tract infection. Gynecologist, dealing with uterus and ovaries. Ophthalmologist, dealing with eyes, optic nerve, everything. Diabetologist, dealing with the sickness of rice and sugar level or insulin level. Gastroenterologist, dealing with the digestive system. And oncologist, dealing with a disease called cancer. Okay, so all this you have to know. This is not only English but also general knowledge. So you should know all this, and you should know when you go to a hospital, even you can help others to meet the right kind of doctor.